Hey, we're here with Broke But Rich Overland in this epic Land Rover Defender 110. We're gonna walk around the rig and take a look at some of the detail, interior, exterior, anything you wanna see. Before we get into it, why don't you tell us a little bit about Broke But Rich? I mean, what are you guys doing?
Broke But Rich basically started when my first overland trip, I didn't have a name for my trip, and I thought, you know, if you're gonna make a trip and meet memorable people along the way, something like a story behind. So Broke But Rich is basically for the people that think that this is something impossible, that you know, that you must be a lawyer and then retire to do this, and it's I just want to prove to people that it's totally achievable if you set your mind to it and you're good at saving and spending some time.
Awesome. That is an awesome message. I mean, that's what, I mean, the overlanders that we run into, that is a very consistent theme. You can do this. If it's something that you're interested in, there's a way to do it. That's an awesome message. This thing is like a tractor. I mean, it's a 70 horsepower motor.
70 horsepower.
Is that right?
Yeah, the usual swap of the motor is very normal with these cars. It's something you must do.
Yeah.
Broke But Rich, you know?
Yep.
We don't have a lot of money, so I decided to, instead of getting on the highways and getting frustrated, we said, you know what, let's stick to the trails.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need a lot of speed, and we'll get to our destination, and we'll get to see the scenery a lot better and getting to know the towns, the real towns of the U.S. along the way.
And now you guys have been on the road for a while. You started in Florida.
We started in Florida,
Miami.
I actually had no experience whatsoever in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
I've been living in Miami for about 16 years, and I only left once to go to New York. So we built it in Florida. We both have a Brandon and I in the Jeep have very busy work schedules. And the reason why we're able to do this is because our job is seasonal. So we get about 3 months where usually people find another job, or if you're, you know, mentally preparing for a trip, you can save enough and live a simple life throughout the year, work a lot, and then be able to take off for 3 months. So we were kind of lucky that to have a job to let us do that. But the saving part is probably the most, especially living in Miami, living simple is very difficult.
Yes, when everything I can imagine.
Is so expensive, and just the lifestyle or the people drive you to do things and drink and, you know, things that can get really expensive.
So
I cut down the drinking and the going out part. I can still do beers at home or a friend's house. It increased my budget. Tremendously.
That was part of the thinking. You had to plan around it.
Yep. I mean, I love beers, but you know, I'd rather have my beers at home.
Rather have fuel.
Yes. So now I think fuel. I'd rather have diesel instead.
Right. So, all right. Let's talk about this rig a bit. You guys are sticking mostly to the trails and off-road, though you go back and forth between the two?
We go back and forth. The trails are beautiful, but sometimes it can get repetitive, especially when you don't see much along the way.
Yep.
So we try to skip a few parts where it can get a little tiring, a little boring.
Mm-hmm.
We switch it up, go back to the highway a little bit, get a little bit of, you know, back into society more or less, you know, taking civil showers and getting a, you know, maybe a getting supplies also from supermarkets and stacking up again to go back on the road, because sometimes we don't run into a lot of shops or anything to buy stuff.
Right. What's your highway speed in this this 70 horsepower diesel beast?
Highway speed varies on flat surface, and if the wind is not against me, I could do probably 70 miles an hour.
Holy cow!
And if I can trail a big truck that covers the wind, I can get up to 70-65, but probably the average speed has been about 55 55 miles. Like I said, this is a very agricultural style motor and transmission, So I treat it that way.
I don't get frustrated. Somebody told me once that you have to think of these as a tractor. They're somewhat SUV in shape. But
there's nothing SUV about this.
Right, it's more like a tractor.
I mean, you don't get AC, you don't get power steering. So when Brandon is usually leads, because he's got all the heart maps and the navigation on the truck and the navigation on his phone, and he's got power steering and no shifting, he can deal with that a lot more than I can.
Yeah.
So when he makes a U-turn, I get really upset because it takes a lot of muscle to turn this thing around. And a lot of...
Okay. So you've got a winch on here. What did you, what do you have? It's a, looks like a Warn?
It's a Warn winch. It's a 9500. It's a high speed. So it pulls a little quicker. I've yet to use it in our trip. But it's a great tool to have at all times, especially when you're in remote places.
Yep. And Hella lights?
Hella lights, they're halogen. You know, wish we would have run the LEDs, but you know, they can get quite expensive.
Yeah, so, this is what I have on my truck as well.
They work great. They're, you know, pencil beam, so anything that's ahead of you in the trail, you can see. For more of a wide range, I use the LED bar.
Yep.
That gives me more of a wide range. Almost like having bright HIDs in your car.
Can you stand on this?
Of course. That's how I get it. I don't have a ladder, so that's how I get to the roof.
Right.
Just jump on this.
Right. I always see the tread. I always see the tread plate. And
you can pretty much walk all over the truck. You can jump down. Yep. And nothing ever happens. Can you do that with your SUV?
No, you can't. No, you absolutely can't.
So, I like that. I like the fact
that
I'm in the trails, and we went through very difficult terrain with branches, and I see everybody's car scratched up, and here I am.
Yeah, yeah.
Nothing to worry
about. They should be. They should have a little bit of desert pinstriping.
Yeah.
Now, okay, so here's your spare, clearly, just because of the positioning of it. You can see it's not really an obstruction in terms of visual.
Actually, it is.
Is it?
When we're going uphill and we have to make a left turn after that, I have no idea where I'm going.
Gotcha. So then you have this blind spot.
If you're going up, all you see is tire, and then you're like, I'm just guessing there's a road there.
Yep, got it. So it does impact your line of sight.
My girlfriend sometimes guide me on the left, which could be a little bit of a blind spot. If you've been going uphill and then it's hard to see through your hood, imagine having an extra tire on the top.
Yeah.
But other than that, you get used to it.
Yeah.
And you kind of...
And this is your shower water, right? You put this up here to heat it up during the day?
Every day it's up there.
Every day. That is
just
awesome.
Just in case.
Yeah.
You always need a shower, especially after being on the trails. You get a lot of dust and stuff and sweat and this and that.
So. Yep. All right, let's continue our journey around this rig. All right, so you've got the snorkel on there.
Actually, the snorkel is I built it. I saw the kit they made for it, and I kind of replicated what they were doing.
Yep.
So.
And I'll bet it works fine.
It's been working great.
Now I noticed when I looked earlier that your roll cage, it looked like it is integrated into the inside as well.
Right.
Right.
The front part from the back of this window, it goes through the outside and it protects and it connects with the roll cage, the roof rack in the front, and then it protects the outside of the windshield, and then from here back it's on the inside.
And this is a two-door, clearly it's a two-door 110. Is that more or less rare than the four-door 110?
The 110 four doors are more popular. For what I use it for, having the two-door only, it actually helped out where I don't have to get rid of anything in the back, and I have a longer space for open area where I can put my toys and clothes and whatnot. So it's been great. We sleep inside, so we built it into a camper. So we're out of the elements and, you know, any animals that were trying to harm us at night.
And these, the ventilation is a simple just door.
Flat
handle on the inside, you push it, it opens.
Opens.
You get outside air.
And
that's
you get
it.
Outside air.
It's awesome.
That's about it.
Sliding windows,
sliding
back
windows,
and forth.
Just like the series strokes.
Yep.
Lift up handles.
Mm-hmm.
So pretty primitive.
Utilitarian for sure. Yep. Less to break.
Yep.
Water or whatever else you want in there. You're using the BFG Mud Terrains.
Mud Terrains, yeah.
How have they been on a long journey? I mean, I drive mine everywhere, but how have you found them on this rig?
Well, before this, I was running the, which I actually have an extra that's spare in the top.
Okay.
So that's a Michelin XEL,
uh-huh.
which is a military tire. Very rare, very hard to find
mm-hmm.
In that size. And I was running those before the trip, and a last minute change was to put the BFGs.
Mm-hmm.
The ride comfort increased tremendously.
Mm-hmm.
They're very, very noisy, the other tires.
Got it.
These went from, it's like we put pillows on the other tires.
It was wow.
a night and day change, and now I'm happy with them. I've been on the trails, rock climbing.
Yep.
You can see it on the sidewalls.
Did you, Did you air down today?
Yes, I aired down to around 20, 22 pounds.
Okay. And I'm just wondering, these are E-rated, mm-hmm. I think, E-rated sidewalls.
Yep.
So very tough sidewall, you can air them down considerably. Okay, let's see. Awning, it's a 270 degree awning.
270 degree awning from Foxwing. Foxwing is the model mm-hmm. made by Rhino-Rack. It's been great for us, except for one day in Daytona Beach where we opened it in the beach and it popped open
a little bit.
So it comes with two spares, and luckily I only broke one. Mm-hmm. I was able to replace the little rod at the end.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so it's been working fine ever since.
And then you've got
so
LED lighting for outside.
LED lighting for camping. Yep. I wanted to get these two on the bottom of the awning. Anytime we camp, we have light underneath here.
Mm-hmm.
In case we need to be out here for any reason or get to the water, we're not in complete dark.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Great. All right. This is very handy. Man, this is a very cool setup. So let's just start with cooking.
Cooking. All right.
Here.
So the first idea was to build a box and have the kitchen already built in here.
Mm-hmm.
But that was going to take out probably about 6 inches of space, which means less six inches of sleeping arrangement inside.
Yep.
With your feet go, this will go and take off 6 inches.
Yep.
I'm already kind of almost on the door
uh-huh.
without this, so
mm-hmm.
we decided not to mount it and just leave a floating table. So I was gonna do a slide out, a cutting board and mm-hmm. all that, but it was gonna add too much.
Got it.
So we went simple, just mm-hmm. a simple table that drops down. We strap this down inside, and then we take it out when we're cooking. This
Great.
Is just for extra support on this part right here.
Mm-hmm. And then, so it looks like you have quite a bit of storage all along one side here.
Yes. Basically, I wanted to block the side that I don't look out when I'm driving.
Okay.
So this windows right here, I've never used when I'm driving.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to leave this side clear, so when I'm driving, I can see out and
yep.
do not have a blind spot.
And just pointing out for folks, this is a right-hand drive Defender 110, which is why you look out these windows.
Yes.
Where we're used to.
Yes. Initially, I was planning to do everything here, and then I'm like, wait a minute, I'm on this side, I'm gonna block this side, so we have to change the whole layout.
Yep. Yep. And then you put down. So this does this fold out?
Yeah, so
like it folds
I wanted
out.
To do a little demonstration on how it works.
Yeah.
Have a folding mattress
mm-hmm.
that also turns into a sofa. So when we're cool. inside, we can sit down and eat in here.
Uh-huh.
Then I take this off at night, and then you have a lot of more room without the thing, so we can get in here and sit down or lay down mm-hmm. For a quick nap. So this underneath, it's all storage for our food.
Yep.
The stuff that we don't use every day. So we buy big packs, and then we put smaller packs in here, the mm-hmm. ones we use, and then when they run out, we get it from here.
Mm-hmm.
So this lifts up here.
Okay.
Now you have pretty much a lot of storage on
yep.
here. And then this goes over this way for the bed.
Got it. Yep.
And I hope I don't get the cable for the fridge. There's water jugs.
I see.
But this will fold
yep.
like that.
So that's flat. Uh-huh. Put your pads on it, and you've got a nice bed
yeah.
back
so
there.
So when it's really hot, I just turn on the fans here. And I got a dual fan set up here.
Uh-huh.
And then that will keep us nice and cool and keep the sunroof open.
Man.
Should be more than enough.
Yeah. And you can just see, looking at the framework on the inside of this thing, how tough it is.
The bolts on the roll cage.
Yeah, all the bolts on the roll cage and a complete inner frame. It is a tough rig.
Yeah.
Cool.
It actually helps a lot with stability on the
track. Yeah, because you don't get the flex, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's just very, very stiff, very rigid. Okay.
Yep, and then just storage on this side.
Mm-hmm.
Last two are for clothing and bathroom supplies,
yep,
and all that stuff. This one is just all the kitchen supplies.
Mm-hmm.
Once we're cooking,
oh, very nice.
We're very close to it.
Yep.
And when we open the bed, this is the only accessible drawer.
Uh-huh.
So we keep our clothes that we might use every day, our mm-hmm. underwear and stuff like that, where we don't have to keep opening and closing the bed.
Yep.
And then this is all our bed stuff, cutting boards, thermo, and our fridge.
Cool. All right. What else? You've also got storage here. You've got another door.
Yes,
similar
that's
to
fuel there.
To the other side. So you have fuel here.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And some standard shovel.
So the jerry cans would just fit sideways perfectly here.
Oh, got it.
They don't even move.
Yeah. You've got two of them in there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, cool. And what do you keep on the top?
On the top is basically all the stuff we don't use every day.
Mm-hmm.
For example, we have our camp tent for showers, and
mm-hmm.
if we need to use the bathroom, a portable potty, all the extra clothes for winter.
Yep.
If we make it to Alaska.
Yep.
And
you'll make it to Alaska.
Yeah, spare parts, spare filters, and anything that we might need in the trip that
uh-huh.
doesn't need to be down here. Just
cool.
out of the way. I have an extra tire back there just in case.
Now, I think folks would probably be interested to hear just a little bit about driving this Defender. Maybe you could tell us, you know, what's it like to shift? What's it like to, you know, to use the brakes? How does it feel? Just tell us a little bit about it.
Driving is, it feels like you're driving something big and heavy.
Yeah.
Not having power steering and just the tire on the, it feels like he's driving a small tank,
mm-hmm.
pretty much, which
mm-hmm.
is a cool feeling, you know, to when you're driving around, you feel safe and secure.
Yep.
But basically steering, it's fine for me. I've had right-hand drive cars before,
mm-hmm.
so it's not so hard to get used to. The shifting on this one is pretty high up, like a truck.
Yep.
In first gear is almost like you have to
you
so
have
much.
To lean out of your chair
yeah.
to put it into first.
That's the only thing that it's a little uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm. What is that handle right there?
That is a choker.
That's the choke. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Got it. You turn the key on? Do you have to let your glow plugs?
Yeah, and this one is it's an older model,
uh-huh.
so it's in the key. You turn in halfway,
mm-hmm.
you're in accessories, and then you turn it halfway before you start, and it will glow the plugs, and then you can start it.
And then do you use the choke? Like, will you use it tomorrow morning if it's...
No,
just the glow plugs. Why do you use the choke then? If it's cold?
If it's cold, mm-hmm. or if it's having trouble starting,
mm-hmm.
which I've never had trouble starting.
Cool.
Yeah. And then we try to keep it nice and clean in here, but it gets a little messy sometimes, like right now.
Yeah,
I have
course.
A bunch of sweaters and stuff. So this is a Fat Mad.
Uh-huh. Sound.
Rattle Trap. It's
yep.
soundproofing.
Uh-huh.
I pretty much did the whole entire bottom of the car and,
mm-hmm.
and the sides, and it increased the ride comfort a lot more.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot quieter on the road, and on the engine you can hear a lot less, and also keeps the heat or the cold out, which is pretty cool.
Now, you said there were no accessories, but you have a sunroof. That's luxury.
Sunroof.
That That's
is probably
luxury
the
there.
One thing that is luxury in this car.
Oh, that's awesome. You got a fan in there. Cool.
Yeah, that's my AC.
Yeah, that's your AC.
And,
are they stock seats? Did you use the stock seats?
These are Exmoor trim.
Okay.
So this is a Typhoon's model of the Land Rover 110. So they got refurbished by Land Rover in 2009. I think, believe this one was refurbished in 2010. So they got brand new seats, brand new suspension, and all that stuff. They pretty much did the whole interior.
Cool. Awesome. Okay, what else should we know about your rig?
It sits a little taller. I got a 2-inch lift by ARB, which have saved me tremendously, because we're carrying about 6,000 pounds right now with us in it.
6,000 pounds.
A little over 6,000.
Yeah.
We went to a weigh place where the trucks go and the scale. Highway.
Yeah.
The scales, and we pulled up and we asked the guy if he can weigh ourselves, and the guys gave us the printout. So I was about 6,300 or something like that.
Wow. Yeah, that's a lot of weight.
Yeah. So the lift helped out on the trails, going over rocks. Mm-hmm. I have yet to scrape anywhere. So I'm
proud of that. How stiff is the suspension?
The suspension is actually really soft. Mm-hmm. It's a nice ride on the highway. Sometimes a little too soft, but that's because I don't have the stabilizers in the back.
Mm-hmm.
But that gives me a little more... what's that called? Wheel travel.
Yeah. Right? Okay. Did you take the sway bar out?
Well, actually, this one did not come with it, and I was going to put it in. But since we're going to stick to trails, I decided not to, because it was going to be a little rigid on the trail, and this way gives me a lot more flexibility.
Mm-hmm. Really cool. Okay.
Came in handy in Moab.
Oh, I'll bet. Yeah. Going into four-wheel drive, how do you do it? So you don't have to flip hubs or anything like that.
No switches. The only switches I have are for the lights.
Uh-huh.
You have two levers on the in the middle, one for shifting, and the second one, the little one, is for the low gear transfer box.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, it's a permanent four-wheel drive, so I don't have to adjust any of that. But it's on high at all times. I do have to come to a complete stop to put it in low gear, and then I can shift all five gears through that.
Got it. Okay.
So in probably low gear, I can get up to 35 miles an hour.
Mm-hmm. In fifth.
In fifth.
Yeah. Okay.
Which is cool if you're cruising up hills.
Yep. Yeah,
little extra power.
All right. And ARB, is this ARB bumper?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. ARB bumper,
limb risers, which came in extremely handy on the Transamerica Trail.
Uh-huh.
A lot of bushes and very narrow trails.
These did very well, huh?
Yep.
Kept
all the branches away from the windshield.
And you've got your turnbuckle with plenty of space so you can tighten this up as it stretches out.
Exactly.
Oh, that's great. Cool.
Trying to keep it simple.
The more simple it is, the less.
Yeah. Trying to do more with less.
Great.
The least stuff that you put in the truck, the least stuff that is likely to break or to go bad.
Mm-hmm.
So we're trying to keep it going.
Right. All right, you guys. So Broke But Rich Overland. Look for him on Instagram. You guys have an Instagram account.
We have an
correct?
Instagram account. It's new, fairly new.
Mm-hmm. But you're cataloging your journey from Florida all the way to Alaska. Mm-hmm.
And even my previous overland trip as well.
Cool.
In South America, which was my first time.
Mm-hmm.
In a 79 Land Rover Series 3. And it's about 2 months in South America.
Wow.
And that was last year. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's going to be a year and a half now.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have a lot of pictures and stuff that I didn't do much with. So that's why when I came with Broke But Rich before this trip, I decided I would add a little more info on that trip as well.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe something that would come in handy and helpful for people that are trying to go to South America, Patagonia especially.
Mm-hmm.
And some tips.
Well,
and tricks.
The knowledge you're accumulating with your trips is extremely, obviously extremely valuable for other people to learn from as well.
And so. This has been a learning curve for me because, like I said before, I've never been out of Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And, getting to know the United States the way I'm doing it now, it's been absolutely amazing. I get to see every single bit and stuff you don't get to see when you get on an airplane,
Right. No, absolutely. You're seeing it down low.
Yes.
Inch by inch.
Inch by inch.
Well, thank you, Gato. Thank you very much for sharing. Thank you for your time.
I appreciate it.
You guys go and check them out on Instagram and follow their journey.